Hello, my name is Paul Bevan from Siemens Digital Industries Software, and in this demonstration I'd like to take you through the new sketch slot command available in the December 2023 release of NX. In this example, I'm going to use the NX sketch slot to create some inspection holes on the underside of this aircraft wing. So I'm going to start by activating the sketch application, choose the plane which I want to sketch on, and now I'm going to use the new sketch slot command to construct my slots. As you can see, it's very quick. Just pick one point, second point, and then drag for the width of the slot. One option you have when creating slots is to lock the size of the slot so that you can very quickly generate another slot of the same size. And as I touch the center line of the previous slot when creating the new slot, it's automatically aligned. Now I want to create some other inspection holes that line up with the trailing edge of the wing. So let's take a look at how we can do that. One option would be to measure the angle of the trailing edge and input that into the slot parameters. Or I could project the trailing edge into my sketch, or in this case it's just as easy for me to construct a reference line and use that to align my slots. All I need to do now during the construction of the slot is to touch that line, which helps me make the slots parallel to that trailing edge. Again, I can lock the dimensions and construct two other slots that are aligned to each other. I'm going to put a distance dimension in and change that distance dimension. You can see they all update. To complete the sketch, we're going to offset each of the slots. And the reason for doing this will become apparent in the next stage of the process of developing the inspection holes. To start this next stage, I'm going to project the sketch curves directly onto the wing surface. You'll notice they're automatically selected, so all I need to do now is to select the wing surface, the direction of the projection, and now I have my sketch profile laying directly on the wing surface. I'm now in a position to add thickness to the wing skin and include my inspection holes. So I'll activate the surface thicken command and select the wing skin. I have a default offset, but I can dynamically drag that if I want to change it. And now I'm going to use the inner boundary of my projected curves to pierce the wing skin to create my inspection holes. And you can see how easy that is to do. The final piece of this process is to add an area of different thickness around the access hole. This will help to define a recess into which the access hole cover door will be seated. To do this, I select the outer boundary of the projected curves. And again, you can see how easy this is to do. Once I've selected all the boundaries, I can complete the command and temporarily hide the projected curves and the original wing skin, and you can see the recesses for the access hole doors. Now, to ensure I have enough material at the outer wall of the recess, I'm going to offset the recess face. And to do this, I'm going to use some artificial intelligence. I'm going to use select similar faces. I pick one set of tangent faces and then do a search across the whole wing area for any others. As you can see, it's found them. And now I can apply the extra offset to each one of those faces at the same time. And there, that's done. So let's take a look at these recesses in more detail. I'm going to use a section to take a look at the geometry to ensure that I've got the wall thickness that I want and to ensure that the material thickness within the recess is exactly what I want. If it's not, I can go back into my Thicken command, make a change, and again, you'll notice the recess depth has updated, and that's across all of the recesses. So let's just recap what you've seen. You saw me use the new sketch slot command to create some profiles that I was able to use to construct access holes within the wing skin. We took those sketch slots and projected them onto the skin. We then used Thicken to create the access holes themselves together with the recesses for the access hole doors. And finally, we used artificial intelligence embedded in NX to very quickly select multiple faces in one go to apply an extra material thickness. And finally, we were able to adjust the depth of the recess by going back in and modifying the thickness. I'd like to thank you for your time and attention.